Being inducted into the Rock Hall of Fame is obviously a proud moment for not only the Faces but the Small Faces, and it's and I thought we'd been bypassed and forgotten about, but obviously not. And it's better late than never. Mm. But we're really
here's to the Small Faces. Yeah. They were a great band, and the Faces kept that spirit going.
Yeah, right? Absolutely. Yeah, it's exciting.
Yeah, it means a lot personally to me to be inducted twice, because the only thing I remember about the first time back in 89, I think it was, when the Stones were inducted, Pete Townsend inducted us, and he said, "Boys, don't try to grow old gracefully. It wouldn't suit you." I love that. He hit the nail on the head. I don't know what little Stephen is going to say about us, the Faces, but I know he's a big fan, and it's wonderful that he's going to induct us. We're going into Cleveland Thursday evening and ready to rehearse on Friday in whatever format the band takes, because that was our history, is always a risk, always on a whim. We're going to play Stay With Me.
Yeah, that's the
and
one,
we may do an instrumental too, yeah. You know, because Faces instrumentals were quite important to us as a rhythm section.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. You know, we're looking forward to it.
And I'm going to sing Ooh La La anyway, whether Rod likes it or not. When Steve Marriott left the Small Faces to form Humble Pie, Rod Stewart and I were really disappointed that he'd split up that wonderful foursome. And so I asked Steve why he did that, and he had his own issues about, you know, everything was not connected with the essence of the Small Faces. So anyway, Ronnie Lane said to me, "I don't know what we're gonna do, will you come over, Ronnie?" And I said, "Sure, come on, let's play." So we all played with our backs to each other.
Very shy.
Yeah, very shy, and sort of just to get the feel of it, we worked on some Booker T and the MGs or Meters stuff, and just like some funky grooves. We knew we had that. We thought we'd get to a vocalist later on, which Kenny eventually asked Rod, who used to come down with me and hide upstairs at the Bermondsey Rolling Stones rehearsal room. It was where all the equipment was around, and it was a converted studio, and it was a damp basement, but they used to let us use it for free. So the first time properly with Kenny was down in that damp rehearsal room.
Damp bass.
With a pub nearby where we used to do one song and run around the pub to celebrate.
Yeah. Well, we were, yeah, probably the...
A hard partying band, we were, yeah. That was one of the stipulations that it was an unwritten rule, was the celebration factor spread from the band to the audience, and we would give out cases of booze instead of having a support band, so the audience would be in the same frame of mind as the band. Yep. So everyone was nicely wrecked.
Oh God, I couldn't pick one out. There were all crazy moments in the Faces. Like we said, when we played, we just invited everyone back to the hotel and wanted to continue what was happening on stage back at the hotel. It's non-stop.
I think getting the airline pilot in the pool first and the co-pilot, followed by most of the audience that would follow us back from the gig. Yeah. And they would get them all in the pool first and then pick the ones that we liked to party on with us.
I got a call from Bill Kerbishley, the Who's manager, who said the Who have had a meeting and they want you to join the band. They won't consider anyone else. And I said, "Sorry, I can't," because I was starting a band which was made up of two Americans, two English, and we'd had a deal with Atlantic Records, and we were just about to sign the contract. And he said, "Well, come in and meet Pete. He's coming into the office." So I went into, always happy to meet Pete, because so we talked for about 2 hours, and then he said, "Come on, you've got to join." He sort of persuaded me, and then, you know, it's not that I didn't want to join. It's I just felt that I was letting people down, that, and especially having come a long way with the new band we were doing. And then it kind of peaked, sort of the emotional side got in, and I said, "Okay, yeah, all right, no problem." And then I went back to the band that we were forming, and I said, "Look, I can't, you know, I've got to do this." And they said, "Look, we totally understand. Just go ahead." And that's why I ended up doing it, you know. And I've got to say, I would have given anything not to have joined, because I wanted Keith Moon to still be there. And when I joined, I didn't want to emulate him in any way. Just there's certain things you have to play in this, because in the style of the drumming technique, but in the main I kept it pretty much me. Genesis Publications published a book of Ronnie's art, and one thing led to another, and they wanted to do one on the Faces, and
their quality is so high, the reproduction and the paper that they use, you know, the quality is just beautiful, that they wanted to do a picture of a book of pictures that through the years. There's one photographer in Detroit, for instance, Tom Wright, who took some very meaningful pictures of the faces in that chapter of our lives, and Detroit was like our second home, wasn't it?
And then we all sort of dug into our personal library of photographs, which we don't often get out, you know, and that brought back, it's amazing what we found in there, and then we put that forward into the book as well.
Some of the pictures brought Kenny to tears, you know, literally. And me, it was kind of, oh yeah, I didn't, you know, I forgot about that, or I didn't want to be reminded of that, but it's lovely that it's there forever.
Yeah. I didn't realise we fell over so much. Every picture we're on the floor. Right.